rooftops. What you have said in the dark will be heard in the daylight, and what you have whispered in the ear in the inner rooms will be proclaimed from the rooftops. The Lord is speaking about the balance of our lives, that the natural and the spiritual works together, that whatever we do in our lives, we should make sure that we live them both and both equally well, that whatever we have put aside, and if it's bad, it'll become known. If it is good and we've not proclaimed that, it'll also become known. But the Lord, what the Lord goes on to say in the book of Luke chapter 12 verse 8, he says, I tell you, whoever publicly acknowledges me before others, the Son of Man will acknowledge before the angels of God. There is a song that says, so I shout out your name from the rooftops, I proclaim. How many of us are waiting in our lives for a higher moment, a greater moment, so we can shout out and tell about God's goodness in our lives? Jesus said, if you cannot be faithful with little, you can never be faithful with much. Sometimes we do not understand what our rooftops are, purely because we are looking for bigger things to praise God. And God says, how can I give you bigger things if you have not learned to understand what you have in little? That the little you have is great for you. The little you have, you have not acknowledged. The little you have in your life, you let it go. You've taken it for granted. You have not come before me with glory, praise, and honor. You are looking for something substantial. I've given that to you. You've just not understood it. You are looking for riches. I've given you wealth. You are looking for something in someone else. I've put it inside of you. You are wanting to praise me by the evidence of what you see in somebody else. You have not looked at yourself. Inside of you, I've planted the greatest seed, a seed of goodness. I've created you after me. I've created you in the greatest wealth that you can ever have. I gave you a good, healthy body. You have not spent time saying, thank you, Lord. To give God praise, you need to find your worth. For many times in our lives, we are searching for the worth. But the very worth we are searching for is what we are carrying. We are as wealthy as we are healthy. So if you are a healthy human being, you should not wait for another moment. You should stand before God and say to the Lord, Lord, I want you to forgive me. Forgive me that I have not understood you. I have not understood your worth. I have not understood my worth. I have not come before you in thanksgiving. I've not come before you in praise. I was looking to give you something after I receive it. I was waiting for things that I never knew I had. I was waiting for opportunities and you've put them inside of me. I was waiting for potential. You've put that inside of me. I looked at potential in another human being. You've put it inside me. I look at substance that would come from somebody else. You've put it inside of me. Lord, today I want to proclaim your name from the rooftops. I want to tell you from the bottom of my heart how grateful I am to understand my worth today. Today I know I will walk out a different person. I will not look at what I don't have, but I will look at everything that I have. I will look at my worth, my wealth, and whatever I do from this moment on, I know that I will be adding to my wealth. Whatever I do, whatever I achieve in finances, it will not make me wealthy, but it'll just add to the wealth I already have. So any riches that I bring to myself will add to my wealth. Any acknowledgements, Lord, I will shout out. I will let it be known to my friends, to my family, to the public alike that you are my God. You're the one God that has given me the bread of life and given me a healthy body. I have forgotten who I am. I have forgotten that though I am placed in a position that I cannot see the tomorrows, I cannot see my potential thereafter, that your word says in the book of Ecclesiastes, chapter 4, verse 14, that the youth may have come from prison to kingship, or he may have been born in poverty within his kingdom. Today I know that my circumstances doesn't dictate my future, that where I'm placed today will not tell me that I cannot be where I want to tomorrow. I know today that I am the son, I am the daughter of the Most High God, that I've been born a prince, a princess, a crown prince, a king, a queen in the making. Today I know who I am, knowing that, Lord, I will proclaim your name. I will make sure that whenever something good happens in my life, it is from you, for all good things come from you. That the rooftops doesn't have to be a great praise. That standing on the rooftops and saying thank you is to acknowledge you in all things. Today I realize who I am. I realize the things that I have not been. I realize my worth. I know my worth. Start off your day with a kingdom language. Greet somebody a good morning. Greet them a good afternoon. Greet them a good evening. When your day is good and you greet somebody a good day, you are speaking the language of royalty. But when your day is a day of struggle, is a day of trial, and you still greet someone a good morning, a good afternoon, and a good evening, what you are doing is speaking from the rooftops. By saying to somebody a good morning, when you yourself know that your morning is nowhere near as good as you'd like it to be, you are speaking from the rooftops. You are saying to God, Lord, irrespective of what I feel today, of how my morning is, I want you to give my brother, my sister, a Godful morning. By telling somebody a good morning, you are standing on the rooftops and saying to God, give this person a Godful morning. The Lord listens to those kind of people. The Lord listens to those kind of voices. The Lord stands to attention and says, somebody call my name. Somebody proclaim my name from the rooftops, because I know their day. I know that the day is tough today. I know that there's certain difficulties in that day. But my son, my daughter, has not hesitated to wish goodness upon his brother, upon his sister. So let's give my son, my daughter, that has proclaimed my name from the rooftops, a good day, a good week, a good month. The book of Numbers 14:28 says, so tell them, says the Lord, as surely as I live, declares the Lord, I'll do to you the very things I hear you say. All good things come from God. When you express goodness to others, you are expressing the God in you. And the Lord says, by doing this, I will do the very things back to you. To give God praise, glory, and honor, we first need to receive it. A journey to work, getting to work on time, getting to work in good time is reason to give God praise, glory, and honor. To be able to crack a joke and smile on your way for somebody to light up your day and for you to light up theirs is reason to give God praise. We need to stop looking at bigger things to stand before God. The greatest things in life starts off with little things. If you have had the privilege of watching a little child draw, you will see that as this child draws and colors, the child will take the drawing to their mom or dad for approval and for praise and for a little bit of glory. And I haven't seen a parent in my days, in the time that I've lived on this planet, ever say to a child, you are doing a bad job. I've heard the parent tell the child, stay within the line, your colors are good. That looks like me. Who is that? That looks like your dad. Who is that? The child would say, that's probably my friend. I've seen praise given constantly to a child. Stop trying to fix up things and take it before God. Take your problems to God as they are. Don't try and color within the lines. Take it before God. Let him show you how. That by leaning on him, calling upon his name, trusting us on his understanding, that he can show you that all things are possible through him. Keep our country in prayer. Keep our government in prayer. Pray that the word of God will rise up and that our government, our politicians, will do good and make the right decisions for the country. There are some really good people in government. For some of those who has not done good, there is still goodness in them. Let us pray that the goodness of God rise up in our government, in our politicians, that they will do what is good for this country, what is good for South Africa. I still believe and I know that South Africa is the pillar of Africa. Stay blessed. Have a good day. The Lord bless and be with you. Amen.